bunny. He really showed up. I'm impressed. I didn't think you'd be up for something like this. I thought you were a little princess. I thought for sure you'd be too scared to break a few inconsequential rules. After all, it's just an abandoned building. If they really wanted to keep you alone, they would lock it up. No, I haven't gotten in here before. I have no idea what we're going to find. What if people live in there? What if there's dogs? I bet you'd like that. But they might be strays, so you might not be able to touch them. The place is pretty big, and we are in the middle of the woods, so what if there's a bear in there? Exciting, right? You don't know what's gonna happen, but that's the fun of it. No, don't worry. Because it's your first time, I'll be extra careful. I won't do anything risky. I'll make sure that you are safe. Yeah. Well, if there are any wild animals that are hungry for your skin, you run for it, and I will stay back for you. How about that? We'll have our own little Titanic ending. I'll be Jack. Chivalrous, right? Romantic. No, not really. But I'm responsible for you. Bunny. I'm not gonna quit calling you that until you stop being one. Yeah. Until you stop being all scaredy cat. This is a good first step, though. So, did you bring a flashlight? Did you bring some water? I brought extra in case you didn't think about that. Well, we can't have you just wandering around in the dark, just stumbling into things. Sometimes there's holes in the floor in places like these, and you can fall in. You don't want to be feeling around in the dark. You always want to know where you're going. Trust me, nothing will happen. I'm careful enough. I've been in these situations before. And trust me, it is very rare that anything dangerous will happen. Just don't step on anything that looks like it could fall apart. How about that? Yeah, that was very needless to say, but... But that's how little you have to worry about while you're with me. Hey, if you're scared, if you're that scared, why don't you hold my hand and I'll guide you? Don't slap my hand away. I was trying to be nice. Are you ready to head in? Well, don't let that freak you out. I broke the lock before you came here. I had to do it in advance. I wasn't going to carry around bolt cutters around a building. Seems a bit unnecessary. Besides, these places, they're abandoned. Why would they ever have any locked doors inside? Okay, if you get really curious, and if there is a locked door, we can go bust it down, alright? I'm sure all the doors are just falling apart of there. Yeah. Alright, come with me. Are you sure you don't want to hold my hand, pussycat? Okay. Flashlight's on. Oh, I forgot to tell you. This is an abandoned asylum. You know where they kept the crazies. I hear it's haunted. That's why I chose this place. If I really do get to see my first ghost, I'd rather it be with you, Bunny. Oh, cool, you see that? They got hospital beds just littered all down the hallway. And there's straps on them. This place must have been filled with real insane people. How likely do you think it is that one of them stayed behind? How likely do you think it is that someone still lives here? I hate no backing out now. No, you can't leave. We're halfway down the first hallway. Come on. Look, okay, fine. If we hear anything, we can leave. That's it. If we hear something, it's not us. It can't be the wind. I'm not leaving for a gust of wind. After all, what they say about this place is you can't find it on any maps. You can't find any articles about it. I only heard about it from this old lady running the antique store. She said it's really hard to find your first time. So if you do find it, leave some markers. So I did. And here we are. I'm sure it just wasn't marked on a map. I'm not trying to spook you too bad. Well, I am a little bit. Is it working? You blop. Hey, what are you doing there, girl? It's just a piece of ceiling. Rats live in these places, and when they're scurrying along the inside of these cheap ceilings, yeah, they're basically made of dust. If you've ever been in a hospital, or I'm sure most schools use them, it's very cheap soundproof stuff. See, it's right over there. It's just a little chunk of ceiling. And if that even fell on our heads, it wouldn't hurt. Okay. Would you rather I brought an umbrella to hold above your head? Come on, don't be such a scaredy cat. I promise it's just rats. Rats are cute anyway. You know what, if they cause us any problems, I will demand to see their leader, okay? I'm sure his name is King Radicus III. Now I'll give him some cheese, and he'll leave us alone. I'll be stupid as much as I want, thank you very much. Hey, no punching the tour guide. It wasn't that bad. Oh, cool, check this out. There's this room that's caged off. I wonder what's in there. You want to go inside and check it out? I swear I won't close it on you. That would be really fucked up. Well, come on, Bunny, follow me. I'm leaving you behind if you don't. I'm kidding. Oh, this place is just filled with papers all along the floor. There's an old printer here. There's all the junk. Try to kick it. Fine, that won't disturb anything. I don't want us to get haunted. He's so scared. Now why don't we keep going, man? How am I not scared? I don't know, this kind of stuff doesn't really scare me. The scary situation. Well, I wasn't exploring an abandoned building. But when I was young, I was camping with my family. This has to do with like a wild animal experience. So here I was biking down the road, and like 9, 10 p.m., it's like pitch black. And I wanted to go take a shower because, oh my god, this summer was boiling on. I was sweating so bad. And as I'm biking down the trail, there's no lights, by the way. All I got is a little headlamp on my bike. So I'm just going down the road, and I hear a roar beside me. Well, maybe like a growl. Probably remember it louder than it was. And I look over, and I see a bear. It's just standing in the bushes, staring at me. All I see is its head, with the light from my bicycle reflecting back at me from its eyes. And I froze. I didn't move. I didn't know what to do in that situation. But nothing happened. That was it. It just got bored of me, I guess, and turned around and left. So I went and showered. It's not like that would happen again. It's not like it's going to chase me down. So, yeah. Yeah, it was a good shower. And then I went back and I went to sleep. What's the scariest situation you've been in? This? What do you mean, this? This place is empty. There's nothing scary about it. Besides, you have a big, strong man to take care of you. Doesn't that make you feel a little safe? Yeah, I don't blame you. If I was a little guy, if I was a wee guy, I wouldn't want to go somewhere spooky either. It wouldn't feel too safe. I wouldn't feel very protected. That's how I'm imagining myself in your shoes with a little guy. I don't want to freak you out, but yeah, I've noticed as we're walking, this place is getting slowly less dusty. Especially on the middle of the floor, like something's been walking in this direction a lot. Maybe something does live here. Oh, spooky. Oh, don't worry. Anything can explain it. I'm just trying to freak you out a little bit. It's funny seeing you quiver like that. Whoa, check this room out. They got such fancy furniture in here. This must have been like a private institution. There's no way this was public funded. Look at those red seats. It looked like something straight out of Fallout. They look real expensive. Hey, I got an idea. Next time, how about you help me take those chairs home? I'm sure we could clean them up. You and me, a little project. Huh. Nobody owns them, it's not stealing. We can always keep them and say we found them in the woods. Yeah, you can leave out a few key details. No one has to ask any questions. It's easy. It's easy to leave out details. Well, I left out that this place was supposedly haunted, didn't I? And I didn't seem the least bit bothered by that. I just wanted something fun and interesting to do with you for the first time. I'm quite happy you came out with me. Before we keep going, I just want to check up on you. Are you having fun? Is this okay? Because we can always turn around and leave. We got this far, true. Why don't we just sit in here for a bit and check this room out? Maybe we'll see some fancy books about psychology or something. Maybe we'll find a book on how to do lobotomies. Wouldn't that be funny? See little diagrams of people getting their brains ice picked? Gross. Okay, fine. Maybe it is a little gross. But you never know what you're going to find in these places. Well, this couch looks pretty nice. It's not ripped up or anything. Yeah, let me brush the dust off. So, sit with me, bunny. Right beside me. I'm just taking the atmosphere. Yeah, I like to do that. I like to just sit here when I go into abandoned places and just enjoy the feeling. Yeah. I like how cold and destitute these places feel. Makes me comfortable. What's up, bunny? No, I don't mind if you lean your head on my shoulder. Go for it. Do you mind if I wrap my arm around you? Too late, I already did it. You're not cold, are you? Good, good. This place is pretty nice. It's definitely one of my better finds. Yeah, I've been to places cooler than this. Sure, I can take you. Seems like you're having fun no matter how scared you look. I'm glad to see that. Makes me happy. You have something to confess. Yeah, you can tell me anything. You don't have to worry about how I'm going to react. Because of my tattoos, what? Oh, and because of my hair, what? What do those two things have to do? Oh, I look big and scary. Okay. Is that the confession? No. You thought I was a fuckboy. Don't worry. It's not the strangest thing you've ever heard. You thought I was a fuckboy and you still came with me? What does that say about you? Huh? You're too anxious to turn me down. I hope you're not always like that. That could be really bad. Depending on who's asking you to do what. Yeah. Oh, is that why? Well, I think you're real too. So how about that? I'm glad it wasn't the other thing. I'd feel pretty bad if I dragged you out here and you actually really didn't want to be here, and every time I'm asking you, you just didn't want to make me feel bad, and I know how anxiety gets. So I'm glad you're not like that. Everyone's a little anxious. Even I'm anxious right now. There's such a beautiful bunny lying up on my shoulder, talking to me with her pretty voice. And she's been hopping around this abandoned asylum with me, quaking in her boots at the little spooky noises. It's very cute, and I like feeling like I'm keeping you safe. No, you. Let me get a better look at you. I closer and kind of way, staring into your eyes. Yeah. I'm just gonna go for it. That'd be quite a story to tell the grandchildren. Oh, how did Grandpa and Grandma meet? Oh, well, Grandpa stole her away and took her to a haunted asylum and stole some kisses. Whoa, you really did that? That's crazy. Say that. I was just imagining a funny scenario. Nothing wrong with that, is there? People can fantasize about whatever they want. And I can't say I'm not fantasizing about taking us further. This couch is, well, I would like to take it home, but if it breaks, it breaks. Baby. Bunny baby. I'm gonna take you now, okay? Lean your head back. Leave a mark on your neck. Pretty bunny girl.